New York State attempting to flush out RSV and the flu using a method that helped stem the flow of COVID-19. I spoke with local experts on an expansion to an early detection system that focuses on wastewater testing.
New York State ready to get down and dirty to tackle the ongoing trifecta of RSV, the flu, and COVID. Governor Hochul's office this week announcing $21.6 million in funding that will expand the state's wastewater surveillance network.
It just gives us more information to tackle this huge challenge.
Professor Yana Liang of UAlbany and Associate Professor Kate Meyerdirks of Siena College were among the Capital Region pioneers to see the potential of using wastewater to track COVID trends. They say such findings can help public health agencies know where to pool their resources.
You can amplify that gene or several genes so you can know whether there is this virus or not, and then if your technique is good enough, you can quantify to tell how many of the viruses are in a given volume of wastewater.
It allows the state to use those resources more efficiently and target the places that really need the support.
The state's existing network helps track COVID and polio. The new funding will add pilot programs, testing for more pathogens like RSV and influenza. Meyerdirks says the confidential method using wastewater will be particularly useful, similar to the later stages of the COVID pandemic.
Wastewater testing doesn't rely on people self-reporting. So you tend to get a better sense of what's happening when there's not widespread testing.
And of course, we needed to ask the obvious.
The smell. Mm-hmm. How do we deal with that?
Yeah, so when we're out there, some of our samples are a little bit stinky, but I also have two kids, so it was never worse than, what we deal with on a day-to-day basis at home or that our healthcare workers are handling.
There is processing step to remove all of the other undesired components, then you can just focus on the virus.
The RSV and influenza pilots will launch first in Erie, Onondaga, Jefferson, and Westchester counties. Their results will then help inform the future expansion of wastewater surveillance for these diseases.